possible to be perfect. And you're right. What you and I need to understand is what it means to have a perfect heart. I'm not talking about sinless perfection. I'm not talking about living in a flawless existence. Here it comes. Make a note of this. Perfection, this is important, according to the Word of God, refers to completeness or maturity. Colossians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10 tells us, in Him dwells all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and we are complete in Him. How many know now that we're saved, now that we are children of God, we are complete? Somebody say amen. See, without Christ, there's an emptiness, that voidness in your life. So many people try to fill it with drugs or alcohol, right? With immorality, with perversion. Some people try to fill it with hobbies and education and knowledge and science. Others try to fill it with money, right? And then we try different ways to fill that emptiness, but yet nothing ever satisfies. It isn't until we come to Christ and we surrender our heart to the Lord that we become complete. The definition of and the Hebrew and the Greek word is exactly the same. It refers to, watch this, uprightness, having neither spot nor blemish. In other words, being totally obedient. John Wesley, the great Methodist preacher, referred to it as a consistent obedience. How many know sometimes it's easy to obey the Lord? Sometimes it's relatively easy to obey God. But then sometimes it's not so easy. We find it very, very challenging. And so as a result, oftentimes we compromise our obedience, or we have delayed obedience. We have our idea of what obedience is. For example, let's go back to the teenagers again. If you have a teenager in your house, right, or a preteen, and you say, okay, come on, get off the cell phone, get in there, and wash the dishes. It's your turn. And what does your daughter say? I am. Turn off the TV, get over there, and start doing your homework. I will. Now! I'm gonna do it just not right. No, but see, you wanna do it when you wanna do it. Not when mom and dad tells you to do it. And that's not obedience. Come on, somebody. What am I talking about here? I'm talking about having a responsive heart. A heart that responds readily and quickly to the voice of the Holy Spirit. Hello? That's what I'm talking about. That when God speaks to you, that when God deals with you, you respond quickly. Everybody here, right, has these things. I see three lights. I guess they're filming for Facebook, right? Everybody here has cell phones, right? Now, some of you still have a landline. You have a landline? How many have a landline at home? Okay, a few people have a landline. And many of you have jobs, and if you give somebody your work number, now some of you at work, if you give out your work phone, this is where I work, this is my phone number at work, that means you're telling me that it's okay for me to call you at work. Now some of you cannot take calls at work. You'll get fired. But some of you can. So if you give out your work number, you're telling somebody, when I'm at work 9 to 5, if you give out your home phone, landline, you're telling them, listen, whenever I'm at home, you can call me. It's okay. But when you give out your cell phone number, you're telling me you can call me anytime, any place, anywhere. Hello, somebody. Any day, any week, any month. Just call me, man. Call me. If you need me, call me. So we call you. We call you. And do you answer? No, we get your voicemail. Hello? I can't come to the phone right now, but leave your name and number, and I'll call you right back. No, you won't! Now, Pastor Linus, I wouldn't give him an A+, but he's actually pretty good. Of a lot of the pastors, I'd say A-. He's almost there. Sometimes maybe, you know, it'll take a couple hours because he's busy. I understand that. He's actually pretty good, right? But there are some oh, my God. My son was horrible. My son, you call your kids, I call my son, and he wouldn't pick up. So I would text him. I'm right here, Dad. What do you need? So I text him back, answer the phone. I don't want to text you. I want to talk to you. Help me, somebody. He says, Dad, he answers the phone. Dad, I go, I know. You don't want to answer the phone. But I'm not your pastor. I'm not one of your leaders. I'm not one of your friends. I'm not your homeboy. I'm your dad. I brought you in this world. I'll take you out. Maybe five more look just like you. Answer the phone! So now when I call, about 80% of the time he answers the phone. Amen. Learned his lesson, huh? But that's what we want. It's when God is speaking to you and God is dealing with you, you answer, yes, Lord, here I am. What is it you need? Okay, so the question is, how can I have a perfect heart like David prayed for? Well, we need to understand what a perfect heart is. Number one, a perfect heart is a heart that is open and searchable. Turn to Psalms 139.